So in the shop, I usually forgot the time. So what I need is a clock. In Germany, we need a chainsaw license for cutting trees in federal forests. So when I made my chainsaw license, I got two slabs of alder wood. First, I removed the chainsaw marks with my plane. I draw a circle with my compass. And now I start at one point and mark with the same distance. I do this to divide the circle in six pieces, and after that I will divide it again by two, and then I will have 12 pieces. 12 pieces for one for each hour. Now I need a smaller circle. So now I can use my compass and mark it in the outer piece of the circle. That should divide. That should divide the six pieces into 12 pieces. And now I have 12 pieces. Each piece 1 hour. But the problem is I want to use the pieces inside out. Because of that, I need a triangle with one angle 30 degree. So now's the question, how do I get the inside out triangle? So I set my compass again to the outer radius, and then I start to draw circles. So I need this for each line or for each point, each of the 12 points. It looks a little bit messy, but in the end I get what I want. So and the last one. And our flower is finished. So to get the triangle with a 30 degree, I need to connect one point in the outer circle with the point the leaves meet. So I set my compass to the corresponding radius. I hope the effect excuses the massive amount of waste. I should have planned this better, because now I have this knot in here. But I don't care. I have to do this on that piece again. Cut pieces out with my bandsaw. So I don't know why, but it cracked. Okay, as you see, this alder stuff clogs up my bandsaw very quickly. I tricked the pieces with my block plane and sanded them on the belt and sander. To get the right angle, I always check with my angle gauge. While I sand the pieces, please consider to subscribe if you haven't yet. I try to publish a video every other week. Give it a little contrast. I resawed a piece of walnut to little stripes. I planed and smoothed them with my plane number 4. And again, the belt sander. I glued each piece of the cake to one stripe of walnut. And I used my colorful clamps until the glue dries. The next step is to glue two pieces together. And I used again my fancy clamps. Now it gets a little bit hard because I had the problem how to clamp them. So I used one piece on the right and one piece on the left. The third piece comes in the middle and there comes the clamp which provides the pressure. I hope that works. And yes, it worked. Clean the back, I use my table saw. And now the final glue up, the two pieces are glued together. The center of my piece is a little bit rough, so I decided to drill a hole and put a dowel in it. Then I need to drill another hole where I can put the clock mechanics. I forgot to mark a circle, so I use the dowel. We have a solid in the middle, so I can use this as a pivot point for the compass. Then I only had to trim every piece on the bandsaw. Clean it a little bit with a file. Then came the interesting part. I trimmed the bark from the slab into pieces and sanded so that they fit between the walnut stripes, because each piece of bark is unique. I had to mark them with numbers. A little tip, Roman numerals are much easier to write down, especially on rounded wood or on rough wood. And now it's glue up time. So it was a little bit hard to glue everything at the same time, so I had to do it in steps. After a little trimming with the disc sander and smoothing with my random orbit sander, I used four pieces of wood to make a jig for my router, so I can recess the mechanics for the clock. In the end, I needed a knob for the center of the clock and I used a piece of bark. I cut it roughly round on the bandsaw and then used the disc sander to finish it. It needed a hole in the center for the nut. In the end, I finished it with boiled linseed oil. And then it was time to assemble and mount it.
So, I'm not that happy with this project. As you see, it's very dark and it would be better if the pieces of the cake would be a little bit lighter so that you can read the clock better. But in the end, it's a shop project, so I don't care. By the way, this is my entry for Dominic's challenge tree. Challenge tree. And I will put the link in the description. Thank you for watching. Please consider to follow me on Twitter, Facebook or Instagram. See you next time. Until then, keep your blade sharp. Ah, and check out my last project. It was a little bit small, but maybe it's interesting for you. Bye.